Okay, today I'm doing a calculus cheat sheet video. Many of you have asked about that, and I'm going to do one for you here on my programs. There's no better cheat sheet for calculus than my programs in your titanium calculator. You load them in there. And really all you want from a cheat sheet is a formula and how to do the problem step by step. And to solve the problem so that you can either memorize it or learn it or help you. You're not interested in learning it, not interested in memorizing it. I understand. Even better though, in my programs, you can add your own variables in my programs where you can't on a cheat sheet. So therefore you get the actual calculations and the actual answer. A cheat sheet gives you formulas. That's the first thing in my programs do when you run my programs. I give you the formula. And you write that on your paper, the first thing, to get started. And then you go from there. So let me show you about my menu a little bit here. To get to my menu, you have to press index, put in this formula here, index 8, close parentheses. You do that by pressing second alpha on your calculator and putting in these letters INDEX. And then you press alpha again and put in the 8 in the close parentheses. And then you press enter and you're into my programs. You have vectors, notice A and B vectors, and you have X, Y, and Z vectors there also, but if you only have two vectors, you can put a zero in for the Z factor. And you scroll down, look at acceleration, arc length, chain rule, concavity. I do graphing by hand in my programs. Critical points, there's more graphing by hand. Cross product is a vector calculation. Curl for calculus 3, definite integrals, definition of a derivative, which is really difference quotient here. That's the first week of calculus, very, very difficult, and very, very useless. Dot product, all kinds of things here, e to the x integrating e to the x, exponential functions, and implicit differentiation, that's always good. Also, all the way down, many different things. Even have something for money in here if you want to find out the time value of money, equations for calculus. Of course, we have the quadratic equation, which you can either just get the answer and just by putting in the variables in your equation, or I do it step by step for you if you want that. Quotient rule. Speed, calculations for a sphere, midpoint, sphere equations, volumes of a sphere, radius, and of course trig and half angle formulas, which are very important because your calculators cannot enter secant or cosecant, and you need to convert those to sine or cosine to be able to do that. And plus I gave you the integrals and the derivatives of those trig functions. There's no step-by-step, it's just memorization. So check out my website, www.everystepcalculus.com, and now also www.everystepphysics.com. Don't forget my physics programs. And have a good one.